When I'm Mark Govier here for my case, and this tip is about the trigger, how to start the golf swing. Now, we see it a lot with many golfers, whether it's amateurs or pros. I always remember that classic one with Garcia when he played in the USPGA, when he kept sort of re-gripping the club, something like 15, 20 times before he hit it, and it shows how pressure can affect people. Now, one of the key things I find with the better player is generally they have something that starts the swing off. A certain motion, a certain action, or something that starts the swing off. And I want you guys to go out there and try to start doing this. So you build a routine, okay? You may be coming behind it, you're having a couple of practice swings for each shot. This could be part of your pre-shot routine. It's great. Then you go into the shot here. Now the next thing is, what starts the motion off? Sometimes when I watch people, I see them, they take their setup, and maybe they're taking four or five looks at the target. No, one, two. You can see the self-talk comes into it. The longer you're over it, the more tension you're increasing, and the more the self-talk will come in. So what I want you to try to do is, when you step into that golf ball, that sort of go time, so to speak, you want to be going into that golf ball, and you don't want to be spending too much time over it. So what I would suggest, and this is a good one that I coach a lot of people to use, is once you get into your setup position, the next thing I want you to basically do is, once you're here, is set up, one look at the target, check your square, then the second look at your target, that's your trigger. As soon as you look back at that golf ball, you pull the trigger. Okay, so as you're hitting it, you're feeling there, as you pull the trigger. So, same again, sort of show you this. Take your setup, one look at the target, second look at the target, that's my trigger. So I'm trying to feel, as I do that, that's what starts me off. Stops me from hovering, stops the tension from coming in, stops the self-talk from coming in. Don't do this, don't do that. There's trouble left. You've got a good card going here. All those little things that come in. For my view is, if you don't know what you're doing by the time you go in here, spending another 10, 15 seconds over it isn't going to help you. So make your decisions back here. Select your club. Choose the shot you're going to hit. Have a couple of practice swings. You work on the technical part of the swing. But then when you come into here, try to build something. It doesn't have to be that. It can be your own thing. It could be taking a setup, one look, one waggle, go. Whatever it is, it doesn't have to be what I show you, but what it does have to be consistent. It does have to be something that's going to start the motion off each time. So whether it's a waggle or a slight forward press in the shaft after a couple of seconds, something. And try to keep the time frame very similar. What we don't want to do is be spending time over the ball, additional time. So build that trigger into your routine, add something in there that's going to keep that motion happening, and stick to it, and give it a bit of time. And what you should start to see is a lot more consistency in your play and your ball striking. So work on that down the range, work on that on the practice area and on the golf course, and we should see some big improvements. I hope that helps you. We'll see you for your next month's tip.